Hey, what's going on? Tim from Artillery Fishing, and today I wanted to go over loading your Hobie Outback in your truck safely so that way you don't damage the kayak. Let's do this. So the two ways that I wanted to talk about this was, one, doing it with the kayak cart that Hobie sells. The other way is without the cart, because I realize that cart is really expensive, and if you just paid for a new Hobie kayak, you probably don't have a lot of money left over to get other things, unless, you know, you do. Here we go. Make sure you attach this to the back of your Hobie if you have the 2019 edition, so that way your rudder does not get messed up when you are putting this in the back of your truck. Very, very key, not an option.
Not an option.
Step two, roll your kayak up to your truck. Make sure you got enough room. Once you get it kind of parallel to where your tailgate extender is, go ahead, lift up. Make sure that back is resting, so that way your rudder doesn't get messed up like we were talking about before. I got my kayak resting on my bed extender. I'm just gonna slightly move it. I'm just gonna move it over enough to make sure that it is centered. My kayak is resting on that backstop so that way I don't mess up my rudder. I'll then go ahead, lift up. Kayak cart comes out. And I simply push in. All right, so I take mine off the side part of my bed extender just because it's a lot easier to lift up and put it on instead of moving the entire thing over. So if you do that too, make sure you put it right back on. So before we get into loading the kayak without the kayak cart, I did want to go over some tips on strapping down your kayak. I know there's a bunch of different ways that you can do this and people have their own opinions on it. My personal opinion is I don't use any ratchet straps. I only like to use bungee cords. That's just the way it is for me because I don't want to, you know, run the possibility of messing up that kayak that I just paid an arm and a leg for. All right, some quick tips for loading up this kayak on your bed extender. One is I always end up putting pool noodles on the sides and on the bottom, so that way I don't gotta worry about the kayak getting messed up in any way, shape, or form. On top of that, I also make sure that my bed extender is higher than the bed of my truck, so that way I don't have to worry about this kayak bouncing up and down, all right? You don't want your kayak bouncing up and down on the back of your truck. Next one, like I said earlier, is I only use bungee cords. I don't like to use ratchet straps just because I don't want to tighten and cinch down my kayak, especially in these hot weather conditions. Yeah, I'm sure nothing's gonna happen, but I don't wanna take that risk. I'll just talk about real quick how I bungee. For the most part, this kayak as is not going to get out and slide anywhere. This is 85 pounds, it's not gonna fly out of the back of my car, and it's definitely not gonna get pulled out because I have my bed extender with the sides cinched in. If you don't have the bed extender with the sides, then you might wanna look at a different way of strapping this down. But the bungee cords, I assure you, for this type of bed extender, and the way I have my truck, is perfectly fine. Let's talk about it. First things first, I'm gonna take my bungee cord, I'm gonna hook it somewhere at the bottom, and I'm just literally gonna take it and bring it over top. What this does is, one, it helps hold my rods in, and two, it's just gonna help reinforce the no bouncing. I grab a third one that I attach to the tailgate of my truck. I'll slide it over here. Actually, that was a second one. This one right here is the third one that I hook up towards the middle. And I'll just come over and secure these all in my truck. Now I know some people, they like to actually wrap this part right here around the H-rails. I just don't do it. I don't feel it's necessary. I've driven on horribly, horribly bumpy Louisiana roads going 70 miles an hour, and I've not had an issue with this thing bouncing, thumping, flying out, and these bungee straps work fine. Sometimes I'll also take two additional bungees, hook it to the eye bolt in the back, just as a measure, just in case the worst were to happen. But that's just me, because I'm a little psycho when it comes to loading these things up. I mean, it's not really moving anywhere. You're not having to worry about it bouncing around and going all over the place. It's not gonna slide out. It's good to go. One important step before you're done, take this guy off, because it has a big old remember to move during transport type thing on it right there. A good old English language. So now that we talked about loading it, let's talk about unloading it. And this is going to be unloading with the kayak cart. Once again, get out, you get to the place where you're going to launch from, take this sucker, put it on, not an option. Undo your bungees, which is also very easy because you don't have, you know, a whole bunch of rat straps on, dude. Pull your side rails out if you got that type. If not, then you don't have to worry about it. Pull your kayak out just a little bit. Grab your awesome Hobie kayak cart and you're just gonna go ahead and put it in the scupper holes. Once you got those locked in place, oh, by the way, if you didn't know, the Hobie kayak cart does come with this little locking pin device, so that way your wheels do stay locked in when they're inside your kayak. Next, pretty simple, just gonna pull off and go. Voila, there you have it. A couple minutes, you're done. Now that we have already talked about loading up with the wheels, we're gonna talk about loading it up without the kayak cart. Once again, I really, really wanna stress, if you can get the kayak cart, get it. You spent a whole lot of money, your hard-earned money, on this kayak. Do not throw it away by dragging it all over the ground, messing up the bottom, getting dings, getting dents, getting scrapes, and eventually getting a hole into it. It's not worth it. You paid all this money for the kayak. Don't hesitate to spend a few hundred dollars more to get that awesome Hobie kayak cart. And if you really don't want to do it, make your own. Find another off-market cheap one. Just do not mess up this kayak. You paid so much money for this darn thing. I don't want to see it go to waste. That being said, if you absolutely have to do it without the kayak cart, the best way that I have found through a whole bunch of experimenting, just checking around, is this. Simply back your truck up all the way to your kayak to where your truck bed extender is almost parallel with the kayak. You're gonna take the kayak by the T-handle. You're gonna put pressure towards the rear so that way that kayak little caddy thing ain't gonna slip out and fall out from you. Very important, pressure to the rear. You're gonna lift up and you're just gonna move it on. Once again, I cannot stress enough to make sure you put pressure towards the rear, because the minute you pull up on that thing, the kayak's gonna go forward, it's gonna land on the rudder, and you could possibly damage the rudder on your new kayak you just bought. After that, same deal. Pick up. Push. Make sure it's centered, close up, strap up, and you're done. Hey, I'm Tim with Artillery Fishing. I hope this tutorial gave you some ideas. And if you didn't like mine, by all means, use what I did. Take what you like, move something else around, do something that you actually like, and maybe you'll come up with a better way. Thank you very much. I hope you subscribe and like this video if it was helpful for you. Y'all have a great one. Artillery Fishing, out.